Well, she is an Emmy nominee for her work in The Handmaid's Tale as Serena Joy, and rightfully so. Welcome, Yvonne Strahovski. Congratulations on your Emmy nomination.
Thank you.
You're pregnant. I'm so excited to hear you guys. I love her so much in the show. I can't even begin.
Dana,
I've been talking about it all morning.
You were so nervous.
I literally accosted you in the back, in the makeup room. I'm so sorry. I love you. I'm so happy you're here.
Thanks for having me.
We're so excited. Congratulations on the Emmy.
Thanks.
What did you think that your first nomination? What did you think when you got nominated?
I'm so excited. I feel like I'm part of the cool club now.
You sure are. Yeah.
No, it was great. I mean, and so many of us too in the show, which is really nice that we all sort of got recognized.
Right.
The show's so supported, and yeah, it's a wonderful feeling.
And such a good time. I mean, not only to be pregnant, the show's doing so well, the Emmy nomination. When are you due?
I am due kind of like a week after the Emmys.
What?
So I'm hoping that I can even make it to the Emmys.
You will make it. You will make it.
We're I will make it out there. Yes.
Yeah, I wouldn't break your water there.
No.
Just FYI.
Well, you know, I did opt for a darker color just in case of the dress, you know,
better
just in case.
Yeah. That's a really good idea. Okay, you know, really, if you watch this show, the role of Serena Joy is the role of a lifetime because you go back and forth between love and hate and all these. It's such an amazing arc. How did this role happen for you? Were you one of thousands of people that auditioned? Like, how did you land this role?
I went in and I read for Bruce Miller, the creator, and we had a session together, and
right.
I remember doing a couple scenes, and we talked a lot about Serena. She was quite a mystery to me back then because I hadn't read the book and I wasn't familiar really with anything Handmaid's Tale prior to that. So
right.
It was a bit of a guessing game in terms of figuring out what I thought her past might be, and then that was it. I think, and 2 months later, I found out that that it was going to go ahead.
You know what's interesting? I think it's always probably worrisome for an actress to get pregnant, just because they worry about consistency and how it's going to affect the storyline. But in this show, where the entire storyline is about the fact that women can't get pregnant anymore.
Right.
Did that worry you? And how did they handle it?
Well, they handled it fine. I mean, it was the last 5 episodes that I was pregnant in, so I went through all my morning nausea and everything
right.
during filming those episodes. It was just very strange because I play a barren woman, so
right.
someone who can't conceive, and it was just very strange to be going through weird birthing ceremonies and then horrible rape scenes, the things that we do portray on the show
right.
that are incredibly difficult to watch
right.
and do. So I just kind of tried to separate myself, this from
right.
what was going on, you know, at work, because I was super worried about playing someone who's very...
Who's yelling and screaming.
And screaming
right.
and negative, you
That's
know.
A good point.
Yeah.
That's a really good point. So you are so intense with Elizabeth Moss, who plays June. After a scene is cut, can you guys go get drinks? Well, you probably can't go get drinks together now, but can you guys go do something together, or do you try and keep it separate so you can keep your role intact?
No, I mean, we don't necessarily try to keep it separate at all.
Okay.
No, we're like, you know, normal
right.
afterwards. It's all sort of a normal day at work, as weird as that sounds
right.
some people, I guess, because the show is so intense. But
and it's so grim. Can you?
Yeah.
Are you a normal set? Like, you guys joke around with the crew and all that
we
stuff?
We do. Yeah, we totally joke around. It's all good.
Yeah. Okay.
Dana was concerned for
right.
you.
Right.
I was. You know, I've just finished season one. I've been sipping this show like it's a fine wine, and
yes.
I've sipped plenty of wine. So I've been savoring it. But I just want you guys to take a look at a clip of the show, The Handmaid's Tale.
I'd like to be clear. I will not have any more recalcitrants. All of your disruptions and all of your games and your secrets, all of that smart girl bull is finished. Do you understand me?
Don't get upset, Serena. It's bad for the baby.
Oh, God, just every single frame of that show. You know what I was thinking about earlier, too, is you're Australian,
mm-hmm.
and we're seeing such incredible talent come out of Australia. Naomi Watts, Nicole Kidman, Margot Robbie, you. What are they doing over there to grow? It's like a crop. What are they doing over there to grow such amazing talent?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know. I mean, it's wonderful to be in that company. I
yeah.
will say that
you are.
Know, everyone's great. Amazing.
What would you love love to see happen in season three?
Oh, that's a tough question. You know, I mean, there's a big part of me that wants to, you know, join the resistance and be the good girl. But
right.
It's never that obvious, really, on our show. The writers are very clever. They never take the obvious route.
It's never black or white, right?
No, and I feel that's so representative of humanity, you know, and humans. We're never black and white. We're so complicated, and they do that. They really reflect that, I think, beautifully in the characters.
All right, I have to talk about, this is so interesting, is you know Megan. You and Megan have a friend in common, and
yes.
you are involved with the Sierra Club. And you do a lot of hiking and outdoors things. Can you tell us how you're partnered with them?
Yeah, I mean, the Sierra Club, I've been wanting to work with them for a really long time, but I've been in Canada, you know, working on the show. So finally, I got to meet up with them, and they have a bunch of campaigns going, obviously.
That seems kind of dangerous.
Yeah,
it really looks more dangerous than it was. It looks like a sheer cliff. It's not.
Okay.
But
it does look that way.
And you're kind of front heavy there.
Yeah.
Right.
I know. God, that looks like I'm a terrible mom already.
not winning Mother of the Year this year.
No, but they work for the environment, and the environment is, and nature is something that is so important to me, and I wanted to connect with them and do a little campaign about protecting the Grand Canyon, among other national parks and monuments that are at risk at the moment. So, we went over to the Grand Canyon probably like a month ago and did a little hiking and made a video that that will come out soon.
Good.
Here's what Yvonne, she is so bad, like tough, like she's like a surfer girl.
Right.
She hikes for, I mean, what's the longest hike you've ever done? Like days that we're talking.
Days?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. I can't remember.
You like go off and like, I mean, but you would never expect that from
right.
her.
No.
Right?
Yeah,
I mean,
exactly.
She's amazing.
Do you feel the love I have for you? I just want you to know. Like, can
feeling
you feel
all
it?
The love.
Okay. Because I hope you do, because it's here. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank
the
you.
Emmys are September 17th, and Handmaid's Tale Season 2 is streaming now on Hulu, and I love it.
Thank you, Yvonne.
Thank you
for coming in.